Ayo, it's Brian here. Today, going to be talking about the San Francisco 49ers. As always, going to be talking about the 49ers versus Cowboy game that just happened for the preseason week one performance, I guess you want to call it. We ended up winning pretty much 17-9. That's good to get a win. I wish it was a regular season win, but hey, I'll take a preseason win against the Cowboys any day of the week because who likes the Cowboys? Anyways, going to be talking about the video. Going to be talking about this. This should be an interesting time. A lot of good to take away from this, some bad things that I'll talk about in a second, some players that I thought stood out definitely for this performance week one, and going to get to it right now. Also, a lot of injuries, I'll talk about that in a second as well. All right, let's do it. But before I do, please like and subscribe to support my channel. That's going to help me out a lot. Please share this content, share the channel with fellow United faithfuls and other football fans in general. Getting very close to 2,000 subscribers. If we can get to that by week one against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, gosh, I cannot speak today, Tampa Bay Buccaneers, then that would be much appreciative. And I'll probably host a Q&A session with you guys in the coming weeks after that if I get to 2,000 subscribers by week one against the Bucks. Currently at 1963 right now. So, you know, it's very, very close. Just share this content and we'll get there very, very fast. So thank you guys so much. Let's get this video started. 49ers versus Cowboys preseason week one. What happened? Going to be talking about the offensive side of the ball real quick. Some players that I thought stood out were definitely Nick Mullins and I guess CJ Beathard as well. You know, Beathard, I've been pretty hard on him. And I'm pretty sure all you guys in San Francisco are pretty hard on him as well because, you know, we all know what happened for the past couple of years with him as our starting quarterback. But other than that, those two quarterbacks, they had a pretty good performance. One touchdown each, one to Jalen Hurd. You know, the other one to Jalen Hurd as well. So that's pretty cool. They both had an interception, so that's a downer. Also, early on, they had a lot of three and outs. I thought that was a pretty big disappointment. I was hoping to see some more scoring and what have you. But when you have Jalen Hurd on the red zone, then you are almost assured a touchdown. And that's pretty much what happened with these two quarterbacks getting touchdowns. Some bad things that happened also are injuries. Raheem Mostert, and I think Coleman went out with injuries. I forgot what Coleman injury was, but Mostert came out with a concussion, which is not that good. Hopefully that doesn't happen, you know, long term. But still, injuries do hurt. Trent Taylor, he didn't play in this game. He had a surgery for a fractured toe or something like that, so that's not a good sign right there. I don't know, man. These injuries are just piling up like crazy. Not a fun day at the office in terms of that, but other than that, I mean, if you're talking about performance for the whole team, I thought they did a pretty good job, in my opinion. Some other plays that stood out on the offensive side of the ball, I would say Jalen Hurd. He had two touchdowns. Deebo Samuel, he was moving the ball definitely. I think he had about 70 yards over two or three receptions, so that's amazing. He's moving the ball down the field. Who else? Richie James, he's taking advantage of his opportunity. I think that's a good thing that he was able to play this game for the most part. Kendrick Bourne, I thought he disappointed just a little bit, but, you know, it is what it is. Who else impressed? I thought the Titans were really impressive as well. George Kittle did not end up playing this game. In fact, a lot of people were out for this whole game. You got Jimmy Garoppolo, DeForest Buckner, D Ford, Nick Bosa, just all the superstars that are going to be playing 2019 regular season. They were not playing at all. These are mostly just, you know, starters in the mid-card, I guess you want to call it, and players that are trying to make the roster. That was the point of this whole preseason week one against the Cowboys. And, you know, for the most part, I think a lot of people took advantage of the opportunity. Speaking of the tight ends, Ross Dwelly and Levine Toilolo, they had a really good performance as well. So, you know, to see who's going to be with George Kittle come week one, it should be interesting, I would say, for this whole period. I know this is preseason. I know this is just week one, and a lot of teams are not really giving up any information, giving up a lot of good plays or trick plays or anything like that. But still, to have a pretty good performance on the offensive side of the ball, be nice to score more touchdowns or at least field goals instead of just punting the ball away. But other than that, 17 points, can't be too disappointed at all, considering that not everyone was playing like Jimmy Garoppolo and company. What else? Special teams, going to get to that right now. Robbie Gold. I mean, what else do I have to say? A guy that definitely impressed me was Mitch Wishnowsky. I think a lot of you guys, when he got drafted in the fourth round this year, a lot of you guys were disappointed and pretty upset. For me, I don't know. I had mixed feelings about it, but for the most part, if they believe he was the best punter, you just take the guy in the first place. And, you know, he did a pretty good job in this whole game against the Cowboys. He had 50.6 average yards per punt, which is like, wow, that is just amazing. That is like Thomas Mostert of the New Orleans Saints numbers right there. And we need a guy that can definitely punt the ball away if we had to go three and out, unfortunately. And he was able to pin the Cowboys back pretty far in terms of that, in terms of kicking the ball all the way down for a punt. So that was really impressive. I think we found our Andy Lee successor for the first time. Bradley Pinion, for the past couple years, he was kind of okay. He had a lot of bad games. He had okay games, but for the most part, he's not doing what Mitch was Stefanski is doing right now. And I'm glad that the 49ers so far are taking their investments with the fourth round pick and making use of it, because punter, very underrated position. Not a lot of people talk about it, but he did a really good job for the 49ers in this whole session. Offensively, if I had to give a grade, probably give it a B just because of the turnovers and the three and outs. But a lot of players, like the rookies, Samuel and Hurd, the tight ends, the quarterbacks, I thought they all did a pretty good job. And if they can just get in the red zone even more, if they could just score, then it would have been an A-plus performance. But, you know, B performance for the offense, not too bad at all. All right, defensive side of the ball, I was very, very impressed with this whole defensive squad. I mean, considering that DeForest Buckner, Richard Sherman, all those guys weren't playing, a lot of guys definitely showed up. Dre Greenlaw, a guy that I really like from this year's draft, he did a pretty good job in that. He did have a snafu with the penalty. I think it was a holding call, but then he came back with a tackle for loss. Other players that showed up, Marcel Harris, I knew that guy was just going to be amazing. And so far in his whole tenure with the 49ers, including this preseason game, he's done a fantastic job with this team, and I can't wait to see him even more at the safety position. He definitely impressed me big time. Some other players, who to talk about? Who jumps out of my screen earlier? Elijah Lee, he was pretty good as well. You know, for the most part, defensively, I thought they had a good day with pressuring the quarterback, doing all that cool stuff. And you know, I'm thinking off the top of my head, I have the statistics with me, but it's just not on you know, whatever my mind right now. But let's see who else. So Marcel Harris, Dre Greenlaw, those were great guys. Al Jazeera, he had a pretty good performance as well. He had a tackle for loss. Kentavious Street making his debut in a preseason game, he did a pretty good job as well. Two tackles for losses, three tackles and one assist. I thought that was impressive. So, you know, overall, these guys, I mean, new guys, young guys, they're showing that they do belong in the NFL, belong with this team, and they can make a big contribution to this defense when week one happens. And, you know, I'm excited for that. If I give overall performance grade, I'd probably give it an A, to be honest with you. I mean, to allow the Cowboys no touchdowns, to only allow field goals, that's the defense that I'm looking forward to. And this was just our backups when Nick Bosa, D4 to Force Buckner, that whole squad comes back for week one, or whenever they're coming back. I'm assuming week three, they'll probably have another week off for week two, and then the game against, I think, the Chiefs for preseason week three, they're going to definitely show up a little bit, and I can't wait to see what they do then. And then week one, oh man, I think this D-line is going to be nasty. You know, I think all you guys know that pretty much by now. I don't know what else to say, but this defense, Robert Saleh, I think is in the right direction so far. Yes, I know it's only preseason, nothing too crazy, but even when Dak Prescott was playing in the first series, they only held him to a field goal, and that was really impressive. And if they can keep doing that, if the offense can just give a little bit more, scoring more points with Garoppolo as the quarterback, then we can win a lot of games, and that's what we should be doing. I believe the 49ers, they are a very good team. If they can be a good team, just injuries can hold them back, and just careless mistakes, if they can just avoid those two as much as possible, then I believe we can have a very good season, have a winning season, maybe win 10 or 11 games. I know some people outside of San Francisco are looking at me like I'm crazy or I'm on drugs or something like that, but I think it's very possible with the talent and the team that they have. The drafting so far with John Lynch and his 2019 class, I think they look pretty good so far. So a lot to take away in the good parts. A little bit of bad, mostly injuries, I would say, is the bad part. The other things I'm just nitpicking, but for the most part, I thought it was a lot of good for the 49ers, and I had to give a grade of a B-plus overall for this whole 49ers versus Cowboy performance. Hopefully they can keep it up in the preseason. I know it's only preseason. I keep saying that so many times now in this video, but a lot of good promise, and you know, we'll see what happens come week 2, 3, 4 for the preseason, then week 1 against the Bucs. That's it, guys. Wanted to take away this nice win for the 49ers to get a nice W, start this whole 2019 campaign, and hopefully they can keep on rolling. That's it, guys. Please let me know what you took away from this game against the Cowboys versus 49ers. Any players that stood out for you guys? What do you guys think about the Cowboys and what have you? I'd like to hear what you guys have to say in the comments below. If you guys like this, please like and subscribe to support my channel. That is going to help me out a lot. I'll be catching you guys up, I don't know when, probably on a Monday. I'll be off on Sunday, so I'll probably catch you guys up on a Monday. I'll see y'all then. Bye, guys. Love y'all. Y'all have a great rest of your weekend. Go Niners all day. Nice to get that W.